you car.
Good evening. I'm Mike Noondorfer with Advanced RV here in our Cleveland facility, and I'm standing in front of Gayle. So the client wanted extreme nimbleness with his van because he's going to spend a lot of time in the desert, in remote areas. So he wanted a 2500. We start with all configurations with the client's objectives, and then we move into more specific design features from the objectives. But the other thing we have to do in parallel is, along with the client's budget, we have to be aware of the weight that he's putting into the 2500. It's a challenge to build in a 2500 because 2500 is a quite a bit lighter and lighter capacity than the 3500. Many clients now are picking a 2500. The 2500 with a shorter wheelbase makes it a little bit easier to maneuver in tight places. It makes it easier to avoid obstructions when you're in the desert and in the forest. Because it's lighter, it's going to float a little more in mud and sand and be a little more able to handle rough conditions. So while he spent some weight on the grill guard, we worked together to get the weight out of other aspects of this build. It has a fair bit of space, good size shower, composting toilet, designed this himself, picked all the materials, as with all our clients, and it turned out really nice. This has a Revuti sink. It has a filtered water, separate spigot for drinking water, a kitchen sink with a remote squirt mechanism, has a cutting board on top, a drain insert, and then on the bottom there's a grill that's not going to rattle. It has plastic on it. So I think this is an Italian sink, and it's pretty classy. So here's where we store the portable induction cooktop. It has an over-the-cab storage, which is fairly light. It's an aluminum, but it's covered for sound. Separate reading lights at night, or you know, when you're driving at night. This is a portable solar panel that we found a place for when we built it. The client asked for a cooler. It's an electric cooler. It's actually a horizontal refrigerator. Take off the top, and it's got quite a bit of cooling space. It's vented. There are vents we built into the front and the back so that it will maintain its cooling capacity. And then we designed this latch so that it latches tight. So this is an airhead composting toilet. If you want the scoop on these toilets, there's a video by Fit RV that I watched this weekend, in fact, because I've never personally used a composting toilet. And James and Stephanie go through all the details, and after a year's use, how you clean it up, that you have to sit down and separate solids from liquids, and there's quite a bit involved with this, and it really never composts unless you have a place to dump it where you can dump it and mix it. Stephanie and James fill the urine thing up every day, so they have to take it into a bathroom or something and dump it. They talk about going through Starbucks and dumping it out. So what they've avoided by putting in a toilet like this is having a black tank and using fresh water to flush the toilet if it's a typical toilet. So we have a lot of clients that want composting toilets. I think some of them are due to the experiences they've had in other motorhomes. What we typically do to try to avoid those issues is to create space for a lot of fresh water, a large black water tank. Marcia and I usually go a week and a half between having to change tanks, emptying tanks, and get new fresh water. So it's a choice, and it's one of the many choices that our clients make. The shower has a teak floor, nightlight, and other lighting, and then a mixing valve for the shower, waterproof toilet paper holder, medicine cabinet. It has an extension so that the curtain comes out and makes a bigger shower. It's a functional bathroom, and there's a fair bit of space here as you come inside. You don't feel claustrophobic. One thing he did to keep the weight down was he used just cubbies instead of cabinets, and we designed these cubbies so that they would have blocks that would keep the stuff in his cubbies from sliding out. So this is the way he wanted to design it. It's pretty cool. We have our silver leaf control, as we always put in. There's as much storage as we can get in here. This is where the tables rest, but there's also more room, table and the lagoon mount. And then there's quite a bit of storage all up above and down below. We have the batteries and the inverter and all the I.O. for the electrical system is all under the bed. It's accessible and it's very attractive. For one person, I think this is a pretty nice layout. He did a nice job. Has opening windows in the back and in the side. There's another opening window here. These are all windows that are awning type so that they can be opened during the when it's raining. There are two max fans, one in the front and one in the back, for a lot of circulation. You open the windows in these max fans and there'll be a hurricane in here. He's sleeping across in the back. That gives him plenty of room for sleeping. Now, I would have a little trouble sleeping across in this bed, but he's a little shorter than I am, and so he's great with that. He specified a purple mattress. I mean, if you know that, it's a brand. It's an incredibly heavy mattress. It's about this thick, and it's a fairly complicated construction. So we took this purple mattress, we took it apart. We had to make it fit in the back. We cut it down. We recovered it with material that gives it more stability, and then we built a cover for it in upholstery. He wanted to not worry about the van being level, and what he decided was he wanted to be able to level the bed. Right now, this end is high. And bring this down. And these are all manual. We thought about making this electric, but he wanted to have it manual so it wouldn't break or have any issues in the outback. So this is a thermal blanket our upholstery people made to make sure that in the winter he can be comfortable. This isolates the heat loss areas from the main cabin. The client wanted to have a compressor, and these are his air hoses so that he can actually look at the pressure of the tire that he's filling and the pressure of the compressor. And this goes in this. He has his freshwater hose, his shore power, and then this is a table that works when the van is open for outside serving and whatever you want to do. This table goes up like that. The supports fold down into this drawer and close up and go away. This is also a pass-through cabinet. So there's a door on the other side. If you're not using it for this type of thing, Marsh and I put our groceries in here when we shop and then close it up and have access to them from the inside. Like every other advanced RV for 7 years, it has a completely integrated lithium battery system with state of charge indicated. We've put a plug in here for his portable solar panels, and the parasitic power is very low on these units. If the refrigerator is not going, it's about 4 or 5 amps at 12 volts. If the refrigerator is going, it could be 9 amps at 12 volts. But Marsh and I were just in one of our first vans, which was built in 2012, and we had just put a new battery system in. It has less than 400 amp hours of lithium. We were off the grid for 52 hours and didn't do much cooking, but we used everything else in the van except the air conditioner. We didn't use that much. We had about 37% of our battery power reserve after 52 hours of living in it. So with the owner of Gayle's plug-in solar, in the desert especially, he could be pretty much self-sufficient. We're excited to have him come tomorrow. Thanks for watching this video. It's another 144, and it's been fun to build.
Subscribe now to UCar, a point of reference for car fans since 2010.